Welcome back to Calculus 1, and welcome to week 6 of our time together. Can you believe that we've been at this calculus game for more than a month already? And we've done a ton of stuff so far. Way back at the beginning of the course, we first met limits. We explored what it meant to evaluate a function near but not at a particular input point. And once we had limits, we were able to define the derivative. We explored how wiggling the input to a function would affect the output in some way. That ratio given by the derivative. Then we spent a lot of time focusing on how to actually compute the derivative. Right? We've learned all these derivative rules, like the product rule and quotient rule, last week the chain rule, for actually computing derivatives of functions. And this week is no exception. We continue that proud tradition of actually differentiating. But in week 6, we focus in on the transcendental functions. What are transcendental functions? Well, most of the functions that we've been looking at thus far are really algebraic functions. They're, say, polynomials or rational functions, roots. Transcendental functions are functions that transcend algebra, like e to the x or log, functions that we couldn't have gotten to if all we had at our disposal was algebra. Another great example of transcendental functions are sine, cosine, and tangent, the trigonometric functions. And if you're not feeling super comfortable with trig functions, no worries, we're going to review trig functions this week as well. But by the end of this week, we're going to know how to differentiate those trig functions. And that sets us up for week 7. And what happens in week 7? Applications of the derivative. We're spending a ton of time focusing on techniques of differentiation. And next week, we'll see some applications. The payoff is going to be huge. Just one more week of calculations to get through. And then we can see what all of this is used for. Good luck.